out your bloom. Got your own room, getting bigger, making memories like heirlooms.
All my stuff just arrived in a box, and now I'm calling through to see what's mine and what's not.
All the rush that we live with, we were about to burn so we all could fit.
Wait, it didn't start like that. This place was frozen. I mean a real deep freeze. Give help to farm strong folks through Matthew McConaughey. I literally had to sleep in a church. That's a first.
Come out of the storm that you live in.
Y'all, let's talk about some minimalism. Let's talk about how to cull down the things that you own, maybe. I don't know. It's the perils of that. We were just traveling for 3 years, basically. Mom, dad, two kids, two businesses. We just got all our shit back together for the first time in a long time. And we're having to cull through some stuff and also keeping some things. So on this episode, I'd like to pour a little tea and talk about how do we cull down the things in our lives so we have what we need, but we're not overwhelmed with musty, old, dense energy. But listen, first of all, I gotta say, we crossed 100,000 subscribers on this channel. That is amazing. We're gonna be doing a huge giveaway. If you wanna be involved and you're watching this relatively soon to when it's being published, you've gotta be on the list at matterful.co, okay? This is my main website for gear and for culling down the items that we have just to those things that are matterful. It's the stuff and the things that matter in our lives. Right? That actually is gonna contribute something meaningful in your life. Like I started the song with my daughter's 4-year-old birthday, you know, playing in the snow with her out here outside of Austin, Texas, was just like, these are memories we're gonna have for forever, you know? There are some things that are worth having opinions about and that really upgrade your life and allow you to do things. They enable us. And then there's just like waiting to start running until you have a new pair of running shoes, you know? 100,000 subscribers. Thank you so much, any of you who are subscribers out there. If you're not subscribed, get subscribed because we're interested in things that matter, you know? I'm not gonna sit here and banter with you about like, what is minimalism? What isn't minimalism? I think you know what your life feels like. When it's too cramped, it's too crowded, when it's scuzzed up, when it's old and dense, there's just stuff around that we just haven't had we just haven't fully made a decision about yet, or we haven't really even seen in a while. Have you noticed that, right? I love to clean out that energy. We traveled for 3 years, which means we were in a different spot normally every few weeks, some places a little longer than that, right? So moving around was like a little bit of an addiction for me, maybe for our whole family, because it just changed everything. It cleared the air and it gave us the ability to kind of see what mattered to us, right? This is a really big learning for me. Getting to travel around helped me to understand how we really want our life to be spent, the things that we need, like this. See this little kettle? It costs more than the cheapest one out there. This is from Stag. I'll link to this below with my Amazon link. So you can support the channel and give me like, you know, 35 cents or whatever Amazon's offering these days. But I actually really do recommend this product. It is a Stag kettle. They also make gooseneck ones. But I traveled with this. Why? Because it's nice to have good versions of the essential things you need with you wherever you go. So this and its little base plate, I just travel all over the place with, right? It's been a huge help to us. We're constantly making tea and my wife's a damn herbalist, so shout out to her on Instagram. That is something that we traveled with. This rumble roller, this is something that we travel with. I just like the relief it gives me. I don't have to pay for a masseuse. This Sonos Move, I like this thing, You have to reset it every time you go to a new Wi-Fi that you're connecting it to. But then you're not playing through your Bluetooth on your phone, so you can walk away. It's connected to the Wi-Fi. It's doing some magic that Sonos does, which, by the way, is the same forwards as it is backwards. Isn't that kind of cool, right? I, every day, travel and use this TikTok chair, okay? This, you know, it gets smaller down to here. This is how I use it because I think it is valuable to have the stuff that you really, really dig. And I have very small versions of those. Why? Because we lived on the road, basically out of our Subaru, and then, you know, staying at friends in Airbnb's house. So our kit needed to be small. We didn't have a big van. We didn't have a trailer. We had a roof rack on the top. Video about that, you can watch right here. So for the first time in a long time, I've got all our shit together. All of it, which is effectively, you wanna know what it's like? It's like having all your shit show up on your front door. All the stuff you were traveling away from, all the stuff you were trying to avoid, all the decisions that you just were like, yeah, we'll put that off or whatever, right? All of that showing up, you know, which has been really great actually. My closet has basically, it's basically 20 times bigger than it was for the last 3 years because we can fit it all. And it's stuff that I haven't thrown away. Unique items that to me are, you know, they're unique enough to keep around and I just, you know, I can't get rid of them. I can't, and I don't have to because I can just put them in storage when I need to. But it has to be said that there is like a density to the things that we own. Tyler Durden said, the things you own end up owning you. And it became like a rally cry for people with ponytails and opinions about Bitcoin. And that's like, you know, it's actually, it's not wrong. So C-U-L-L, right? Cull. We need to learn how to cull through the things in our life well. As you know, cull stands for capable undulations, love, light. Or contact, unconscious, love language. Right? It's looking at your life and comparing it to the life that's coming your way. Right? It's like, does this serve me any longer? I really like Marie Kondo's language around, does this spark joy? Because sometimes it can be a hard question, like, does this serve me? Is this going in the direction that I'm going in, right? Marie Kondo, if you don't know, has this great book called The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up. And if you want to cull through your stuff, I just think it has to be experienced. I mean, she's got a great Netflix show. You can check that out. But you could also just get the little book and put it by the shitter because it's useful to go through. And then honestly, I have some recommendations on the closet stuff. I do. I think the closet is like the first spot. It's where, it's also where, it's like the heaviest spot. I don't know how your life is actually. You might have stacks of magazines in your hallway, pardon my French, right? It could get, it gets heavy out there, right? But for me and a lot of people my age that I know, the closet is one place where you wanna encounter, you wanna have some personal growth. You wanna like, it's like you can go to the jungles and try your hands with some sort of a psychedelic shamanistic experience, possibly, or you can cull down your closet. I've got more information on that below, a link at this time code. Check that out because there's a quick process that that I've certainly learned a lot from. I'll walk you through it. So you've got your stuff and we need to cull it. We ask a series of questions about it. Check the link below. We're getting closer to understanding what are the things we really need in our lives so that our life feels the way we want it to. And then there's the question of place. Some of us are tethered. We know right where we're gonna be. Some of us like to travel because there's stuff we're running from. And some of us like to travel because there's stuff we're trying to learn. And others of us, like myself right now, are landing in places maybe for the first time in a long time and trying to create a new life. We're here outside of Austin, Texas, because if you're an influencer now, apparently you have to move to Austin, Texas. Joe Rogan sent out like the bat signal. Now everybody with an Instagram account is like, I'll be there. We're out in the burbs effectively, but a natural, like there's a lot of wild nature out here in Texas Hill Country. Both our kids are in school, which it's a really big difference for us. It's huge. It makes a big difference for my wife and I. We both run our two businesses from the road. And it all fits inside a Subaru. You know, ask me anything. Ask me anything. By the way, do ask questions in the comments below, because I can go through and answer questions there, or maybe make more videos in the future. So be sure to subscribe for, because I think we learn a lot when we live minimally. When we're no longer addicted or insulated by, not addicted, we get insulated by the things that we own. It protects us from seeing some of the more maybe harsh realities or just the more vivid experiences that are real and are really happening in life. And the truth is, you may not like the idea of 10-day silent Vipassana meditations or skydiving or whatever, but the truth is that your death is only coming for you. And sorry to get a little macabre on you, but the truth is, what makes life vital is a sense almost of urgency. Do you know the difference between urgent and important? This is like a secret to culling things down. Stephen Covey, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, it's just like basic type stuff, but we all need to be reminded of it from time to time. How much of your life are you spending chasing down, putting out fires that are urgent because something's on fire, versus those things that are important because it sparks joy, or it serves you in the direction that you're going, or it is just more of a type with where we're headed than where we've been, right? Urgent versus important. This is the kind of stuff I get into in the link below on how to cull down your closet. It's a metaphor, folks. It's a metaphor. Because you know what? Just having few things doesn't make you a minimalist. Your death is coming for you. My death is coming for me. Nobody can face that for us. Nobody. And yet here you are. How many sperm fought through that whole process of you being conceived for you to be the one that pops out? You know? So minimalism to me is about shepherding and protecting the vital connection I have with the sanctity of life. Is that too flowery? The vital connection I have with the sanctity of life. That's why I only have 4 kinds of shirts or whatever. You be the judge. So my baby girl turned 4 and it's time for me to head out to dinner. Here's some ideas that I had on culling down and minimalism. Check the link below. Shout out to everybody who helped us cross 100,000 subscribers. If you're in Austin, holler at your boy. Get on the Matterful.co email list to get on this giveaway and any future ones. Thanks for being. Thanks for being. Hope you're all right. Stoked to have a studio so we can talk maybe more often. Big updates from some bag companies soon.
Dad, I want to wear your earphones.
Talk to you later.